Alrighty, it is now approaching 8 a.m., and the two Undercity police officers have called in the bomb squad to make sure the explosives have been disabled. They have also suggested that Picaz return to the station to work with a sketch artist to get an idea of who their suspect is. So what is everybody doing?
Haven't decided yet. Still trying to catch up with where we're at.
I always forget the second D on that when I'm spelling Nar Shaddaa. This is a problem.
It's a tricky word.
Okay, bomb's been disposed of. We're pretty much well clear on this thing.
I think Picaz may have mentioned wanting to get clothes.
Yeah.
I think what happened last is they suggested that we go back to the station, and when I mentioned maybe getting clothes first, they said that they could probably get me some clothes at the station.
Yeah, that's right. The officer wanted us to go to the station because testimony and all that. And okay. Elon would probably suggest that we go ahead and do that.
Because they wanted a sketch from my Force Vision that I didn't tell them that I saw the guy from a Force Vision, but
you just have that a description. Yeah, you have a description of the guy. They want a sketch of him. Elon is thinking go in there, let you give your testimony and whatnot, and find a spot in, like, probably a corner and just disappear.
Kaz still a bit loopy from multiple explosions.
Yeah.
Alright, so you guys are headed out?
Looks like.
Alright, so, you all head back down to the speeder that you hid in the alleyway. Doesn't look like the tarp has been moved at all. Which is good. There are a couple of people in the alleyway again. Looks like different people, actually, than the people who kind of looked at you funny when you came in the first time. But as they see you come closer and they notice that two of you are Jedi, or potentially Jedi, they keep their heads down and kind of try not to move. They kind of lurk in the shadows, kind of move off from your direction.
Picaz crawls under the tarp and into the car.
Elon would probably go over there and take the tarp off the vehicle. Lexa, are you feeling like driving again?
Sure.
That sounds like it'd probably be the best idea. I'm running on maybe an hour of sleep. I probably should hit the hay eventually.
If you feel like that's what you need, then go ahead. I don't have any problems getting us to tonight. Well, morning, I guess it is. It's just dark down here.
That's true. It's still similar to Nar Shaddaa. I am going more by internal clock rather than by physical light sources.
I mean, like, you don't actually have, like, an internal clock, and right?
No, my dear. As interesting as that might be, no, I don't. But I'm referencing more the set clocks that biology has us going by.
Sure, whatever that means. You go ahead and get your rest. I'll drive.
All right. It means I'm used to certain times being day, certain times being night. Let's put it that way.
I don't really pay attention, to be honest. I only use time because organics do.
Alright. Let's just say I'm used to being asleep at least for a good 8 hours when we've been wandering around awake. Anyways, I'm gonna go lay down in the back.
Alright, so at least Aelon's trying to sleep, so I'm gonna make Lexa make a piloting check to see how well that goes.
I'm gonna make a con roll. If it's below 12, then Picasso's gonna fall asleep partway there. Well, what do you know?
You have a minus one, okay.
I mean, he did blow himself up, pretty much, so.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I realized that I should be done on the condition track, and I never actually upped myself on the condition track, and I never took it down on the condition track, so I brought my condition down.
Yeah, but you got healed by Shiloh afterwards, so you probably would be mostly recovered. Although you would have been a lot lower than just one down, but anyway. Aelon, you can fall asleep on the way there. It's about a 25-ish minute drive. Okay, what can you guys see on this map? Because this is the map I tried to do weird things to.
Okay, can see, or Barry Cam can see up to here. That's where it sharpens off to a point. And then where Aelon is at, he also sees a fairly long tube all the way back here, but in a straight line, yeah.
Okay.
I can see quite a bit. I can see somewhat. I can see the line, and I can see the big
space roughly where what I can see.
Okay, good. That's what you should be seeing. Great.
Now to erase all of that.
Oh, you don't want the giant green lines on everything. Okay. Yeah, so you...
I erased myself, I think.
Yes, you did. You did. You don't get another version of yourself. Sorry, Picasso is gone.
He just blinks out of existence.
No sketches for anybody.
I can't see anything.
Can't see anything?
Just a black square.
Does he have sight checked on his character sheet?
The token, I think.
Yeah, the token.
No, it does not.
There's the problem.
Can you see now?
I can see the bottom half and a little spot in the middle.
Okay. I think it's working for you then. Okay, so for those of you that actually came to the police station before, you recognize this place. For everyone else, which would be Kalani and Pakaz, it looks different. It's a 3-story tall building. Some windows, but not a lot. And you're approaching the main entrance.
that's not a good roll.
No, Aelon is passed out in the car.
Okay, yeah, you would have parked. There's some parking around on the street and stuff.
Yeah, no, Aelon probably didn't even hear anybody say anything, and he's probably going to stay in the speeder.
Poke.
Is Kalani actually poking him?
Yes.
With the roll like that? Okay.
Yeah, I mean, it's up to you whether or not you want to actually wake up to that.
What's going on?
We're here.
Here, where? Oh, the PlayStation. Alright. And with that, Aelon will groggily get out of the vehicle.
So I guess I'll park the speeder and get out. What are we giving to them? Have we decided what we're going to tell them? How much we're going to tell them?
As far as basic information, I don't know. I know they wanted to get a sketch of the lizard man from Pakaz, but other than that, I don't know. If they try to do anything with Aelon, they'll probably get snores.
So I guess we just go in and hang out, see what they want.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like. Alright, Pakaz. Here's the station. Go ahead and give what sketch you can. Wake me if you can when you're done, as it were.
Pakaz looks at Lexa, assuming she knows about these things.
Shouldn't be too traumatizing. They'll just ask you some questions, description. Probably some information on what you saw, what you know. Should be over rather quickly.
Yeah, they'll ask you to describe facial structures and such. Nothing too hard if you remember correctly.
Just be as accurate as possible. If they sense that you're withholding things or that you're trying to mislead them, they will not be as agreeable to you.
Okay, so everyone's going in, or is Aelon going to stay in the speeder, or have you all gone out by now?
Well, I thought they wanted us to come inside, so, and that's why I thought everybody was poking, or Kalani was poking.
Okay, Aelon, okay, and then you are in fact going with them.
Yeah, I'll crash out in the middle of or on the side of the wall or something, but yeah.
Yeah, okay, so Oh, I forgot to put two doors. My bad. Hold on a second. Alrighty, so so this front area, Zara, if you remember I was describing, there was like that bullet, the glass, well, the transparent steel in front. So that's those. So the two guys right there are sitting behind that, like where those desks are. That's actually behind glass. I just can't actually make it behind glass because you'd either be able to see through it and walk through it, or not be able to see through it at all. So those are.
Well, you
like,
can. Right. I was just gonna say you can create glass that I think I have. There's some.
Yeah, I didn't figure it out, but anyway, yeah. So you can't actually walk through there. And then there's a door on the left and on the right. And then there are a couple of people in the waiting area again. Looks like all different people than the last time you were in here this morning.
Well, Polka, take your time and all that, as much as you want. I'm gonna find a nook. Behave yourself now, okay? No crawling on the walls today.
Can I just blink? It looks kind of confused. She's looking around.
And the two guys behind the desk, they'll kind of see you guys come in and see you kind of disperse a little bit. One of them like, Master Jedi, what can we do for you? In Eden's direction.
What's he talking to me for? I don't know what we're doing here.
Hi.
Well, I mean, you're out front.
I didn't put myself there.
This is true.
Yeah, but he recognized you as a Jedi, and you're older than the other Jedi, so he asked you.
Okay, then I turn to the others and say, what are we doing here?
I thought Picos was requested to be here.
We have a potential lead in our ongoing investigation.
They just told us to come back here and give this description. I've never been in a police station before, so I don't know.
You're the right sketch artist. Yeah, she'll be out in a second. I was like, and he presses a button. And after a few moments, a short woman comes out and just kind of looks around. Oh, so who was the one who had the description of the suspect?
Picaz wanders forward and says, me.
She'll reach out her hand. Hey, Aaron Almaro, nice to meet you.
Picaz will shake her hand and say, nice to meet you.
And yeah, I'll just take you back to my desk. We'll figure out some descriptions. We'll see if we can make this guy come to life. The rest of you, if you want to come with, you can. If you want to wait out here, that should, well, could it take up to 45 minutes, depending on how easily this goes. But you're more than welcome to wait here or... Wait, Scarlet, I haven't seen you in forever. It's been a long time.
Oh, yes. Well, I've been rather busy.
Anyway, good to see you. Anyway, sorry. My scatterbrain is going all over the place. Let's go, Picaz. I'm sure the chief would love to talk to you, Scarlet.
Yes, if he would like to speak to me, I'll see him immediately.
Yep, you know, his office is still back corner, like it always is.
Thank you.
I believe we were also hoping to get him some replacement clothes.
Yeah, he's just walking in, like, a cloth diaper.
Yeah, as she looks like, she'll turn to one of the guys who's behind the desk. Yeah, can you go fetch him something smallish from,
He probably smells burnt.
From the equipment closet. Yeah, actually, let's take care of that first. So, they'll take you to get clothes. They're not exactly thrilling. They're kind of dark blue, monochromatic. They have
Kaz has always kind of been utilitarian about the clothes anyway.
They're kind of like, it's kind of like a prison jumpsuit, but not like bright colors. Kind of like a almost like a rain jackety material. Fairly comfortable, actually. And it says Doom City Precinct on the chest of it in the left corner.
So you're saying he's not going to be on the any fashion shows anytime soon with this?
No.
I don't think he would have been before.
Is he going to be confused with a prisoner?
No, totally different color.
Okay.
However, if he falls into a vat of bright orange...
No, they use chartreuse as their prison jumpsuit.
Okay, into a vat of chartreuse.
But how would that work? Because it's darker already. That would just discolor it a bit. Not actually,
enough with the logic.
Anyway.
Because.
Anyway. Zeri, Erdo's office is in the top left corner. If you would like to go. Anyway, so she'll take you to the desk and she'll actually be drawing on her computer. Give me an intelligence check.
I have a better idea that fits more in with Picaz, but I will message you real quick and fun.
That's where you just say no and stick with the intelligence check. Because evil GM, right?
She'll just kind of sit back in her chair really quickly. What was that?
That was the suspect.
Oh, so are you a Jedi?
Kaz looks confused and shakes his head.
Anyway, I guess I can see it now, but You want to still work with me just to make sure we get the details right?
I can keep showing it to you.
I'm not sure we'll be able to concentrate that well, but maybe intermittently so we can get this right.
Picard nods.
Yeah, so the process of, like, drawing it out and stuff will probably take... Well, now that she has, like, a really detailed picture of it in her head, she'll want to make sure she gets all the details right, so it'll probably take about 45 minutes. So, does anybody want to do anything in those intervening 45 minutes?
Trying to resist following Aelin's example. Maybe I should make a constitution check. Okay, I think that means I managed to stay awake this time.
Yeah, I mean, you could always choose to go to sleep, and then you might not have to make constitution checks later.
She's already embarrassed enough about she's not gonna fall asleep in the police station or not willingly, and apparently not accidentally either.
All right.
Well, I suppose. Suppose I should go check in with the chief. Do any of you wish to meet him or come with me?
Do you think we should?
He's a decent man. Can't hurt to have allies. Introducing yourself, especially considering the current attitude with Jedi.
All right.
And I'll head to his office.
Alright, so who's all going? So, Kalani, you're going. John, is Eitan gonna go?
No.
Alright. So, as you're walking back, you see a bunch of desks with some cops. Still mostly in armor, actually. Sitting around. Lexi, you know that in the center of this room that's full of offices that you pass, where Picasso went, there's the armory, and then the right half of the building has the interrogation rooms and a bunch of holding cells. And then there's a server room in the center of the building, kind of located right behind where the main entrance desks were. So as you approach, as you come in, you have to knock, but he lets you in. Ah, oh, Scarlet, it's good to see you.
You as well, Chief Erto.
So, how'd you defuse the bomb? Good work on that.
Yes, well, your officers provided me with some material that made it relatively easy.
Yeah, a bunch of adrenaline junkies in the bomb squad, but they do know their stuff.
I suppose so. I got to witness some of their work. Seems as though they are well trained.
Got an excellent track record. I just wish we didn't have to use them as often as we do. Anyway, and who are you, Jedi?
Jedi Knight Kalani Starfighter.
Well, pleased to meet you. So,
pleased to meet you.
You're working on this whole Senate thing, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I forgot that. Chief Zah breathing down my neck, asking for results. I'm like, I just got here. I have no idea what's going on. If you could fill me in, that'd be great.
There was an attack by droids on the Senate building. We defeated the droids and tracked them back here, to the initial location. The droid shop with the...
Yeah, that place you guys broke into earlier and my cop showed up at. Yeah, we had my tech analyst try and find out who the building was run by, but they were perplexed. They couldn't find anything. I don't know. It's weird.
Yeah, sorry.
Well, the locals don't really like to talk to us that much. We haven't found anybody who will give us an ID on the store owner. Yet. But we're looking.
I think all the bank information that I got is on Connie's data pad.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, sorry about the lack of communication at first there. One of our number in our investigation group here is what is the word?
Unorthodox.
Yes, that's one.
Impetuous? Yeah,
I think that's the one I was looking for.
The proper term is reckless.
Sounds
that
like...
That could fit, too.
A lot of people I work with. Anyway. Yeah, so you have anything else? Because we're just at a loss here. I know that, Picasso, was it, is doing a sketch or something there. Those guys called in.
Yes, we hope that that will help us track down the suspect.
Well, hopefully the image is good enough to run through our facial recognition software, but who knows? Sketches are always a tricky business.
Yes, I imagine so.
A planet full of billions of aliens. I doubt very much we'll be able to capture him with the screenshot, but with enough money placed by his name, we might get something.
Yeah, that's true. We all know we got plenty of bounty hunters down here.
There's plenty of money to be made.
It's a good thing we still get some funding. Or, we'd all be broke by now.
Well, as we both know, the senators like to keep the dirty side of Coruscant down in the down below, which means making sure that people like us keep it here.
Anyway, back to this thing with the Senate. Any leads on who actually might want to have done this? I mean, this guy at the shop... I mean, doubt he's the one who's behind all this. Seems like a dealer to me, from what my people have been telling me, what you've told me.
We don't really know much else except that he builds droids that explode. We found a communication indicating that he'd given some sort of remote access key to someone. This key controls these units. But beyond that, we don't really have any clear ideas.
You found a communication? How'd you do that?
Just digging through his apartment, it wasn't anything that really can be transferred.
Yeah, make a deception check. Yeah, he'll buy that. That's unfortunate. Well, maybe we could trace it, maybe find some other communications, but if that's all you found, it's not really that much of a lead other than to further cement the idea that he's really the middleman in all this.
I'm not even sure that that's really a conclusion we can make. I mean, if he's building these droids, he could be also the mastermind. All we really do know is that for whatever reason, he wants the Senator dead, and he's using these droids to accomplish that.
You said you failed to find any information on the droid shop. Have you had any luck on the apartment?
I don't know. I think my tech analysts are taking a look at it now. You can go check out the server room. Actually, you know what? I'll go down there with you.
I'm up to you.
Alright, so it takes you down the hallway, and you can see kind of into the cell block area. There's a couple of officers walking around. Sorry. There you go. I was attempting to move you into the server room, and my mouse was spazzing. All right, so you go, and there's a couple of computers lying in the walls. There's a staggering amount of security cameras on this place, and the walls are basically just all screens showing different angles. And there's one guy in here tapping away at one of the computer stations.
How do you know where to look?
Oh man, Bryn here has got eyes in the back of his head. And
I check because I'm not sure if his species really does.
Yeah, no, he doesn't. You can't really. He's actually wearing. Like, a lot of these guys actually seem to be just wearing, like, their full uniforms, including their helmets, indoors. Which is a little bit weird, but, you've gotten used to it by now. They're just always worried that they'll have to go out into the field really quickly, so they keep most of their gear on hand. Seeing he has company, he'll take his helmet off. He's actually, lost the word that I was going to say. Oh, he's a Duros, actually. So you could kind of tell from the shape of his helmet. You take out his blue skin, red eyes, kind of look out at you. Well, not literally eyes in the back of my head, more like a head on a swivel. Name's Bryn. Wait, you're the Scarlet Hunter, right?
Yes, that's me.
You do some good work. And,
Jedi Knight Talani Starfire.
Oh.
Pleased to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you. So, what brings you all into this, room of observation and surveillance?
The chief mentioned you were looking into the apartment.
Oh, yeah. I was still digging, but... Well, those places... They don't really keep good electronic records. So, it could just be a gap in their records, but I can't find out who paid for room 514. Maybe they paid just with credits up front. Really wouldn't know. The officers are still over there. I'm going to have them talk to the people at the desk, see if we can get some information out of them that way. But the store should have had something. It's got nothing. No records of Well, I've got previous owners, but that was like 5 years ago. We got nothing recent. No sales purchases. No anything. I don't even know what the store's name is.
GM, was there a name on the store physically?
There was not.
Might you have any idea who might have the expertise to do that sort of wiping of any information?
Well, I don't know. We haven't seen anything around these parts, but I've been hearing rumors from my other friends in the surveillance business that, past couple of years, some stuff's gone missing, evidence gone, records of people gone when they've had them in custody, can't take them to trial, they've got no evidence left, no clue how they did it, it's becoming more frequent. I don't know if that's what's happened here, if it's just a coincidence, but no one's been able to pin down where exactly that's coming from.
Sounds like we have a really good hacker on our hands. Someone who's making money by making people's records disappear.
Yeah, I'd love to get our hands on him, because he probably, well, if he's smart, might have backup records somewhere to use as leverage so people don't go after him. But we have no idea who he is or what he is or anything. We got nothing. And this is the first time we've seen any evidence of his work, if that is in fact evidence of his work.
Any connections between what this mysterious hacker has wiped? Assuming it is the same person.
The big ones that I've heard about, mostly crime bosses, those sorts of things, all over the place, not just on Coruscant. Really, I think this might be the first time I've actually seen his work on Coruscant, or even heard about it, but maybe he does lower end stuff like this guy here. We just haven't heard about it. Maybe he's been doing it for a lot longer than we thought. But there are a couple of times when he's made, kind of key witnesses kind of disappear, but not in the way where they get rid of the evidence. They have, it's after they've been to court, given their testimonies, and then, the witness protection program some places aren't exactly foolproof, but managed to make them disappear. We don't know if they were disappeared by the people who were targeting them, or if this guy actually helped them escape. But I'm not sure he's working for any one entity. Seems like he does it for whoever. And that chief looks at him like, "Bryn, why have you told me about this before?" It's all hearsay, man. They've got no proof. I didn't want to just come to you being like, "Well, I think it's this mysterious shadow figure erasing people." But this seems important enough to devote leads and personnel to, doesn't it? Yeah, I guess. Scarlet, you're good at finding people, right? Maybe you can track this guy down.
Perhaps. This person's probably involved in many things. If we could get a hold of him and his records, we could probably find information on a variety of criminals. I'll think about it. See if I can maybe find a way.
Chief looks kind of happy, but he's also just kind of confused as to why he didn't know about this before. Anyway, he'll be like, well, I guess that rules out finding out who on earth this person was based on those records.
Well, keep trying. Maybe, like I said, the chief put his face out for all to see and promise reward. Most people are tight-lipped around the police, but enough money, you can make even the hardest criminals come out of the woodwork.
Yeah, we'll see if that'll work. Anyway, back to my office then. Would you prefer to go wait out by your friends? I don't know. Oh, Darren told me you were asking about that the museum break-in.
Yes, it seemed peculiar.
Yeah, it was.
Okay, out of character, but
you don't know about this.
Anyway, yeah, I've got some files for you. I was putting them together this morning. I got obviously mostly focused on this other case, but that's a real puzzler.
Okay, so apparently this is also in character confusion. Okay, I thought it might have been something that I just forgot.
No, Kalani has no idea what this is at all.
Thank you for that. I'll look this over as soon as I can. See if I can get down to the bottom of it.
Well, that'd be great. We haven't really found anything yet. We're open. Well, we've put reward out for any information. Hopefully that brings in some sort of informant, but we might never find those things again. But they're mostly unfensible, so that's why it was bizarre.
Well, if the person I think is involved, then you won't hear anything further.
Well, good luck on that one.
Indeed.
So as they're walking back, it'll turn to you, Kalani. So, Kalani, how are you guys dealing with all that crazy politics that happened above world?
It is a complicated and distressing situation. And politics are not my particular forte.
Are they anyone's? I think half the time the politicians are just making it up as they go along. Anyway, just for me, I just wish the war was over so we can get some more Jedi down here to help out.
I think most of us wish similarly.
And war feeds a lot of underworld activity, so we've seen a lot of it recently. You don't have the manpower to cover it all, but that's the job. Anyway, I'll let you know if Brynn or anybody ends up pulling any information about this guy. Please keep me in the loop. I'll send backup to help you out if you need it.
I will certainly do my best.